That's good.
Sure is.
I can't believe I just kept trying. I go up last day.
Yeah, we was talking about that.
Yo, we go back, like, I'm gonna go back to like the scene a lot, like, talking about back.
I just restarted the other.
Feels so cool.
Oh, I have the full thing.
Yeah, I said, like, to really come up together.
I see.
I opened it through BBK. Does it shoot you to YouTube now?
I've been there.
So around EBK, it's just kind of.
That's weird.
No, it's true.
That's actually lined up pretty good. Okay. There I am. Yeah, it wants to do it through the app. It doesn't do 360.
That's 3DK.
Stuff away.
That's the thing, the Wi-Fi goes down like every
all right.
2 minutes.
Everybody on this side, you're gonna move because
everyone who comes in the door,
my
who's on Xfinity Wi-Fi, could be taking a part of our
I love this. This is really like,
yeah, I was listening to myself tell you about my wife.
I'm not a fan. I'm a UK site.
Yeah,
he's
cool things. And then what I want to do is just to give you guys some brevity. Oh, what's up, Clinton?
We're recording, so we'll
Oh, we are recording.
Yeah.
Cool. So, welcome everybody to the EBK Gallery Black Boy Jungle rehearsals and sketches. First of all, you can look to the left, look to the right, you can give somebody a hug or a high five. What's up? Because this show is all about unity, it's all about love, it's all about respect.
Somebody give your neighbor a high five.
Awesome. That's what I'm talking about, hugs and high fives.
No one's got no love for the drummer? No one's got love for the drummer?
Oh no, I got love for you, Sam. Got you. Get it. Get on camera too. Get on camera too. So, all of the paintings and all of the art on these walls were created specifically for this show, Black Boy Jungle, that will be at the Town and County Club by Paco Winebox, who is like hiding around or right there behind you. So give Paco a round of fucking applause. Think this brilliant man behind me who hates shout out, Justin O'Brien. Justin O'Brien is literally a, like, I say I need him for everything. You know, Justin's like, there you go. I'm like, yes, I do. He's the man who is helping us do live streaming. Also, any photos from last year and this current year which are spicy was shot by Justin O'Brien. He is the man. I'm really proud for that. This is the Ellis Island Band. I have the lovely, incomparable, gorgeous goddess Keila Miles. My great friend, we grew up with each other in the hood, on the avenue, Arts Collective, Andre Harris. I got the talented and lovely Emily Peterson here in the house representing herself and all the great shit that she's doing in Hartford with Nas and everybody, so give it up. I got Sam Francis King, the king of the motherfucking sticks right here, besides Dwayne, so y'all can have your own drum battle later on in life. Well, give it up for Sam. Shouts out Blue Earth Recycle. I got my boy Dwayne as well, Dwayne Keith, in here. Who's the man? Give it up for Sean. My boy Travis, who used to be my roommate, then just lived down the hall from me in the same apartment. That's my boy, talented, amazing, beautiful singer, songwriter, and guitarist, Travis Golden. So, and then I have the lovely Joe McCarthy, who's somewhere around here too, who is my lovely co-insulation designer, so he just kind of takes a look at the shit that, you know, I do and makes it better, and also adds his own spill to it, which is amazing, and I really love Joe for that, and wait till you see how we fuck this shit up. And then last but not certainly least, I have Miss Aja Echeverria, who is my spiritual mother, my spiritual sister, my goddess, my everything. She's my divinity. She made these three sacred altars: one, migration; the second, divinity; and the last one is land. At the end, there is a bowl at land where you can leave your blessings of whatever wish that you wish, and on the back, leave your email so I can email you. Aja has blessed and made all of these altars to make sure that you guys are in a sacred place where no one is hurt and no one is harmed. And this is the Ellis Island Band. So what we're working on today is an excerpt from the show called Our America. It's an excerpt that I was writing with Alicia Jenkins. And through this, it will have music. We took the classic American 15 50 United States with 13 original colonies, and we turned that into Ivory Africa, our version of 50 50. So it's still rough. So you're going to be seeing us stop. You're going to be seeing people saying no, 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 no. You're going to see people saying speed up. You're going to hear people saying okay, you're a mess. And the lovely Keela is going to be singing as well as I'm going to be reciting the poem. But first, I would like to actually recite the poem first so we can give a little grounding before we hear the music. So, immigrant in America, immigrant of America, our America is afraid of thee, Keela, Andre, Emily, Frank, Francis. Our America is pivotal to your existence, immigrant. Your name will forever be sketched in America's memory bank. Our America has cashed the checks of your last names, Jenkins, Powell, Baldwin, Millsap, L'Ouverture, Jackson. Our America never sleeps, immigrant. Our America never sleeps, never shuts eyes. But our America will never witness you, immigrant. Jewish man stands in his shop waiting for you to buy, waiting and never sleeping. Jewish man has now become the America you now fool, you now fear. Black boy, Syrian girl walks into a room and the building explodes. Mexican man crosses the border. Black boy now becomes the America you now feel, you now fear. Sicilian man harbors families from Libya. Malaysian child prays and prays and prays. Haitian girl now becomes the America you now fear. Irish man dresses in a police garment. African transsexual girl dies. Russian man lives. Native American man has now made you wary. Black boy, Colombian boy lifts his fingers for the first time after being paralyzed for 6 years. Cape Verdean girl grows the first herb after a 7-year drought. Black boy now becomes the America you now fear. Our America wants you to kill the politicians, yet your life deprives you to question. Our America that teaches you to bathe in self-hate, relentless, starving for the insight into my own life and the lies about me, the immigrant, showering, self-loathing, sharing all obligations and responsibilities as a libation of forgiveness to my environment. Black boy, immigrant, communist, God? Color hate defines us. Hatred. The immigrant, an organic part of culture. Black boy, ruined by emotions which he had not wished to have. Plagues of your soul. Black boy, immigrant, white man, God, lynching, bread lines, market reincarnations, and the endless brutalities. Sight pain. Our America, land of unconscious suffering. The city that houses the dead of 12 million immigrants that have forgotten about you. My black boy, my love. Our America can't breathe because it has stolen your breath. It has made it so that you are a skeleton of no flesh, no form. Your soul lingers from the cusp of the physical, the spiritual. Are you digging? Have you dug? Our America has scattered the dirt, planted the seeds, plucked the fruit, root into mangroves. Immigrant, white immigrant, brown skin worker, skinless, jobless people. Did you dig? Did you help lay the foundation of an economy of color? They say white privilege forces blacks, browns, foreigners, and unknowns to grow into the hate that they see in themselves, the hate that white people see in them. White, 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 white. Cringes to the sound of the color, not knowing that they too are foreign to this land, waiting from a natural native tongue, an alien just like I and the rest. Your protective mechanism, your way of avoiding tradition. Our America is shameful, clueless, no of grace. Black boy, your face brings fear. Immigrant, your face brings work. Fear and troubling work resides in America's heart. Truly a travesty. Our America has robbed the blind. You forget their names. Dorval Jenkins, Clee Jones, Bill T. Jones, Deion Jenkins, Alfonso Wilkinson, Deontay Jenkins, Kevin Brown, Richard Wright, Igor Stravinsky, Aja Echeverria, Frida Kahlo, Kyle Wolf, Emily Peterson, Leon Simone, Juan Gabriel, Zakara Trinity Powell, Eric Benkinke, April Lindsay, Shirley Jenkins, Luke Davis, Justin O'Brien, Amy Murley, Tibia, Sonia Sanchez, Nina Simone, Catherine Gunner, Ella Stewart, Bell Hooks, Celia Cruz. Our America embodies the souls of immigrant faces, immigrants' faces that both exclude and include, the land of the free, the land of the homeless, the land of the infected, the land of the class,
the land of the rape, the land of a person who has escaped, who has been forced to leave the country to escape war, the land of the unnatural, the land of the 50 states stolen, the land of skin, the land in which you stand, black boy in America, how can you live? So, with that being said, I'm gonna let y'all do what I gotta do. And I'm gonna stand here and enjoy it. And I may start to recite the poetry over Keela singing. So I'm really kind of looking forward to hearing your feedback on how two voices and two different rhythms sound together. So you heard the poem in its natural, stark way. Now, we're going to hear the song, and we're going to try to figure out how it sounds together. Cool?
Cool.
Sweet. Keela, if you want to sing here, you could too, you know. It's like a great... I can't sing, so I don't know. Because I think it's... No, I don't know. You can leave the office.
Yeah.
Is
this
it?
I think it starts on the floor with like a summertime.
Yes, I get to play something. Wait, tell me my count.
Okay,
no. Oh, okay.
Thank you.
Try these states, but I know that's the hard part for Keila Miles. But what do you think makes it better? What do you think would make it better?
do you think would make it better?
Yeah, great suggestion. Honestly, I feel like it would be
Could you name?
It is awkward.
Could you
like
name places?
Alabama, Alaska,
could you
Kansas?
Name places?
Like
Main Street. All of these, I don't know. You know, God, like just name whatever comes to your head. Name places that come to your head. Yeah. Or yeah, I mean, do you think it would be cool if you make an omelet?
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe it could be places that you want to go, places that you've never been, you know.
Heaven.
So what? That's a place.
It's a place on earth,
I'm in. That doesn't work.
All right,
yeah. You ever appreciate
this
one?
Yeah. It can be Hartford.
This is weird.
It can be Connaught.
I was just,
I
got like a
gig
out, right? And I was like, oh, that's the sound of this
stuff. Good job. You're subtle. Is that what they want? They want you to be subtle? Yeah. But, you know. Cool. I'm like, oh, Travis is subtle on the side. So let's try it from the top. This time, I'm not going to do anything. I wanted to see, how did that feel? It's complicated, huh? To have me speaking and you saying. But I think it's better when she has a mic, because then y'all won't have to fuck with me.
Yeah, it's
a lot easier.
Down.
Wow, wow. That was good. Yo, that shit was fucking crazy. That was epic. Yo, I feel you though. Over there, I'd be like, yes! You give me life. Yes, Keila, you give me life. Great job. Great, great, great job. Notes? Anybody in the band?
I like that part where we had those breaks and it was like everybody was like, stop.
Should we keep that? Because the thing about it is, which
we're gonna keep it.
I'm kinda like how long of Rex Mason is mixing all of the sound, all of the digital sound. So I have to give him the chunks in between. So like how long, you know what I mean? Because he wants to know how long of a pause so that, you know, say we do three tracks that have digital sound and then we have live sound, how long so that the digital sound isn't kicking in while you guys are still playing, you know what I mean?
Like how long is the whole?
Well, that depends on
how
where you're gonna be.
Huh? Oh yeah, you guys went off the dance, right?
Yeah.
But I just like to be free, so I'm like, how long was that? We got. We should.
Like 15 minutes.
That's fine. I mean, look, it was a 75-minute show. It's a 75-minute show. Like,
yeah.
I don't care.
Show.
Right. So
it seems like with that too, the solo parts were kind of building off of how long it takes you to read.
True.
So I think if we time it out, we stay around the general time.
Yeah.
It was like a solid like
15 minutes, huh?
No. 8 minutes.
8 minutes. I would say
no,
like 10 minutes.
Definitely longer than
that. No. Natural Kali?
Yes.
Cool. So for those of who are still with us in the land, they're gonna go over switching the notes. I'm gonna talk to you about. So there is a poem inside the show called Nudity and Love. And in this work, I talk about gender. It's going to ask you.
Are you guys going to back me up on that part?
I'm going to do it. Gender has like ruled my life.
Like, why would you take the song that I know?
As a dancer, men supposed to jump higher, men supposed to dance harder, men supposed to never drop the women. The women are supposed to stay like this, the men are supposed to stay like that. And I always felt like it hindered me as an artist when I got older because I'm always like, well, shit, And then when people say, be a man, I'm like, well, what's a man? And they don't want to be a woman, and what's a woman? They don't want to be a man. And then what's a person? They don't want to be born to anything, and so my partner, even though he's a man, he would prefer to go by they, them, their. They are really important to me, and I think that is really important. I'll read a little bit of it because I'm still kind of not sure with it. But anyway, so there's an old R&B song, My Darling, My Place to Be. I don't know who's singing it. And don't be late. So that is, yes, that is the original Natural Kali. Yes, so, and West India, they love to remix shit all the time. They just like, ooh, what's that? We want to fucking remix it. And they will remix the shit out of it. And Travis and Keila and all of us Indians know. That is true. Okay, anyway, what your ancestors are. So, in this work, I'm going to just read a little bit of it. And Natural Kali is an old song that kind of reminds me of 17 years old at prom. And the song comes on, but they didn't play shit at my prom. Everybody was white, so they didn't play this. But if they did play this, I would be like, yes, get it, DJ. Because this is my shit. But so just to hear, so just to hear a little bit of the poetry. So it says, in life there's pleasure, like the sun hitting your face. You feel your black skin, brown skin, copper skin glisten in the sun's rays. Pleasure, exotic and alive, your spirit becomes as you eat the fruits of my labor. Eat the fruit in the balance of life. Make love happen in the balance of labor. Make love happen. Work. Give libations. Blackboard. Round floor. Board. Board. Hands that touch the inside of human beings, I feel them touch me softly. DNA. Genital. I started to think, when will my life as a woman would stop? This part was originally written for a woman, but it may not be a woman, so who knows? Reincarnate, love, take refuge, pray, and work. I put so much work into love. Now, to give you a little backdrop about love and about why I thought this should be for a woman, I feel that men sometimes most of the times underrepresent women. And it's important to me to talk about that because I feel like sometimes women put so much work into love that men can just go like, whoa, whatever. And when a woman decides to be free and tell the man, no, fuck you, build your own cows, you know, it becomes some whole other shit, you know. Even if a woman becomes a drug addict, you know, she's 20 times worse than a man, you know, than a male drug addict, you know. Or a woman drunkie is 20 times worse than a male drunkie. And we underrepresent the women a lot because of that, you know. And we don't think that we got women like Katie or women like Ann Coverly who can do fucking amazing things in the world, you know. And people like, you know, my mother, who, to share a personal story that she won't give a fuck, because I don't give a fuck, but she was dating a man who was married for 17 years. And that hurt me because I felt like, well, if you can do that to yourself, then what am I doing to myself? Like, how can I love someone if you can't love yourself and you're raising me to love? And I always thought about that because when my oldest brother passed away, she left my stepfather after 17 years, a man that I called my stepfather who was married for 17 years for another woman. And you know, that, it didn't hurt me. It hurt me in a way of, damn, how much time did my mother waste? You know? And so that's why, you know, I talk about, I put so much work into love. I started to think when my life as a woman would stop. Reincarnate, love, take refuge, pray, and work. I put so much work into love. Make me think of sweet grapes. I take one bite, you take three. The truth is that being new in this room is my destiny. Free, like my favorite plums, my corner, my privacy. Alone is where my fruit lies, with naked eyes, revealing truth. I have been subjected to love's role. Smoking from the gun of love, I watch these fruit grow. Thinking about all the times man and love has tried to steal from me, force me to work on your shit, breeding children and classification, picking the grapes as you stand and hold the basket. Told me labor is love, yet love is authentic, love is real, with orgasms, words, arms. You feel the vibration of my fruit's heart, the physical nature of it all, raped into the classification. I have to forget myself, who I know I am, just to love you. Your soul, yourself, your physical being, your crude kisses upon the pillow of life, the fruit you cut into with a knife, the universe connects us like an apple dangling from a tree in the middle of the Mediterranean seas, dancing again with the sticky palm sweat as we eat the fruits of my labor, as one, as many. And there's a second part, but I don't really know about that. But what I will say is, when you eat the fruit of my labor, pain explodes between us, and we must hold back tears. Will you eat the fruits of my labor, imaginary yet so real? I feel too much of this. Keeps me woke and never eating. Keeps me walking in a field full of strawberries, not in touch with my reality, because I can smell the difference. But I want to eat, to continue, and intertwine with my world and the others. You know you love me, even though you never knew me. I tell the future with you in it, the perfect fruit, the loved fruit. You've written love letters on my tongue, and I can't control the universe because she just keeps the love letters flowing like an orange freshly peeled, coming through the portal. I am pretty. When you eat the fruit of my labor, flesh becomes sacred, soul becomes tangible. My fruit makes your body become alive again. Black and brown faces, black and brown men, moving with each other, eating with one another, germinating, loving one another, authentically, truthfully. I would love to see you eat the fruit of my labor. Brown and black faces of the loving one. You spit fire with your tongue. Make sure, never stop. Love your brother, yourself, your non-binary lover. Perhaps this is who we are. Love. We love you no matter what. Love. We love you like we grow fruit. So that's kind of what you might, that's what you made there. Thank you. And so that was co-written by me and Alicia Jenkins, who won't be in the show this year. But I think it's going to be interesting to see how we play on this. My concern is that it may be too all over the place, and I really want to focus on gender, love, and fruit, and underrepresentation of women. And that's important to me because, you know, me being a gay man and never have ever sleeping with a woman ever in my life, not knowing what that pleasure feels like, I've always felt like, oh, well, I don't know what you're talking about because I don't know, you know? And it's just interesting to kind of learn more from women, and all of my best teachers in life were women. So I think that's interesting. So Natural Kali is dope. And they're gonna sing it, and I would listen to it if they heard it. So. Huh? Oh, I did say I was gonna have him sing, but he didn't know that yet. So you wanna sing it?
He knows now.
Yeah. Oh yeah. I want you to try to sing it with her, or together, or going in and out of it. Okay. Do you know the song or no? Not really, but not now. But yeah. So eventually, knowing how it may work. Kilo's gonna sing it today, but this beautiful boy right here, Travis Golden, can sing his ass off. I mean, he sung a song that almost brought tears to my eyes, and it's the truth. I was probably drunk, but still. It was the shit. So, go for it. I don't know who's gonna get, I don't know how you guys
put it. This one's a lot. This one's a great thing. Yeah.
Boom.
Well, that's guitar too, right?
No, not the first one. It's just me.
Oh, I was thinking of the last song.
It's like probably an 8-bar.
Some bass and drums. Rhythm section.
Oh, shit. Guys, by the way, we are still live streaming. Hey! Justin, where you at, Justin?
Thank you.
So we're going to go one more time. Once again, so in the show, I think this happens twice. It does happen twice, though. I'm still casting the part, because it's just like, it's literally a spot part. Somebody may walk out, it may be her right here behind me, but she don't know that either. and I haven't asked anybody yet, but it really is, I'm just like putting people in shit, and they don't know it. But I'm going to try to recite it over here while Keela's singing it over there. I do apologize if she doesn't have a mic. Keela, if you want to stand over there, you can stand over there and I can stand over here so people can hear you. She's happy. So you can stand right there and I'm going to go over there. Thank you all for sticking around. And thank you everybody who's watching us on the live streaming Universe Round. Hey! Thank you. Thank y'all. Thank you, Justin O'Brien, for yelling at me and yelling at you. So, we're going to jump from the top, and I'm going to stand over here, and I'm going to read the poetry to these lovely folks while you guys serenade Aja in the corner.
I'll take it.
Like nothing less. Okay? Awesome.
Thank you.
That was good.
That was a lot of notes.
Over.
I think it was a lot of notes.
A lot of notes, yeah.
Hit it, Mark Burns.
167.
You better Facebook me all the notes. What I can say is, do we ever start Monday morning in Lagos as a band? No?
We started working on it last week.
Okay, so it's nothing that we can play in here, right? No?
I mean, it's a rehearsal.
I just want, we have like 10 minutes left. I just want to try to hear it.
Yeah, maybe.
Just so that I can hear it, just for my physical. Because I'm going to be doing what you guys don't know is, so everyone who comes to the show will enter and they'll be giving a new identity because it's Ellis Island. So you'll come to the show. Hi, I'm here to see Black Boy Jungle. I'm like, oh hey, give me a ticket. And then I give you a new identity card. And it has a new name, a new age, a new gender, whether it is trans, non-binary, whether it's male, whether it's female. And you get a place of origin and you get a job. And some people are unemployed. Some people actually have a physical task that gets used in the show. And during Monday morning in Lagos, they are playing a song. Meanwhile, Keela is like freestyling and she's calling the ancestors to the world. She's catcalling, she's screaming, she's saying whatever the fuck she wants to say. And the whole time I'm asking everyone for their help. I'm gonna say, help! Help me! If you have a card, if you have a task that says, you know, I need you to help fold these clothes, or I need you to pick up these fruit, or I need you to help me, help me. The people who have these cards will then, oh, it says I have to help him. Oh, okay, I'm gonna help him. And then they get up, and then in the middle of the show, you help me. And there's a task. I won't say what the task is, but in the middle of the show, the audience, about 15 to 20 people, undisclosed, they have no clue that they will have a task. And the idea is about creating a collective consciousness to see if those 15 people who are helping me can inspire the whole audience to get up and help everyone, complete the task, and then go back to the seats, or else we can't finish the show. And that's really important. So while they play this song,
the show must go on.
But the show cannot go on without your help. And that is really important.
Great to remember it.
So, so yeah, let's try it.
We want to try and do it with the president. Yeah. I got a couple.
On this Chrome, is that Chrome?
Yeah, or Facebook.
Yeah, that's true.
Thank you.
cut as well. But the lovely dancers of tomorrow's show will be joining us tomorrow, all the way through Friday, and join some excerpts from the show that we will be live streaming and rehearsing. So because the space is small, I probably will be making a dedicated area over here in that area so that we can use all this space for movement purposes. But feel free to invite some of the people. Like I said before, this show is about race. This show is about the myth, representation of culture, and the generalization of culture and race. And about how, and Harper's, I haven't heard anybody talk about it until now. It's important.
I'm